بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. We continue the discussion on the tenderness of the heart, and this is the hadith of Uqba bin Amir, which is hadith 434 in the original collection of Al-Bukhari in the translation of the meaning of these narrations. حديث أبو عقبة بن عامر أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خرج يوما فصلى على أهل أحد صلاته على الميت ثم انصرف إلى المنبر فقال إني فرطكم وأنا شهيد عليكم قال إني فرط لكم وأنا شهيد عليكم وإني والله لأنظر إلى حوضي الآن وإني قد أعطيت مفاتيح خزائن الأرض أو مفاتيح الأرض وإني والله ما أخاف عليكم أن تشركوا بعدي ولكني أخاف عليكم أن تنافسوا فيها. نعم. In this hadith the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went out and offered the funeral prayer for the martyrs of the Battle of Uhud. Now we will use, okay, he went out and offered the salah for the martyrs of the Battle of Uhud, because they need an explanation here. And then ascended the pulpit and said, I am your predecessor, and I am a witness against you. By Allah, I am now looking at my pool, and I have been given the keys, the pool meaning in paradise, and I have been given the keys of the treasures of the earth, or the keys of the earth. By Allah, I am not afraid that after me you will worship others besides Allah, but I am afraid that you will start competing for the pleasure of this world. Now, in this there is evidence that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to visit the martyrs of Uhud. You know, Uhud was the famous battle that took place between the disbelievers, the polytheists, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to visit the martyrs buried on in this site of Uhud, and this salah which he offered, it is not the salah that is legalized to be performed upon the death of a person. That is because the martyrs are not to be there is no salah to be offered on the martyrs. But this is, as Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah asserted, إِنَّ هَذِهِ صَلَاةُ تَوْدِيعٍ لَهُمْ. This is like a farewell salah to them. And in this dalil, there is dalil that his pool is now existing, because he said, wa inni wallahi la anzuru ila hawdi al an, and by Allah, I am looking at my pool. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed that to him until he saw it. And in this hadith, there is evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the keys of the treasures of the earth, or the keys of the earth. However, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not attain any of it. But, not much actually of it, we should say, we correct that. He did not attain much of it. However, his successors, the leaders, the khulafa who came after him, did so. You understand? And in this also, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not afraid for his companions to commit shirk after him. That is because of what settled in their hearts from faith. Now if someone says, well, what about of those who apostated? Who apostated after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? They are not included here because he was not addressing them in this address then. Also, those who apostated, Iman, faith was not settled in their hearts. So they apostated right after the death of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Now, concerning the person who dies in the battlefield to raise for the cause of Allah the Most High, we treat him in this life, the treatment as a shaheed in this life. However, we don't testify that he is shaheed with Allah. The rulings concerning this life is on the apparent. Question: is this salah, which the Prophet ﷺ performed on the martyrs of Uhud, is it particular to the Prophet ﷺ, or is it general? The answer: this is particular to the Prophet ﷺ, and also particular to the shuhada, to the martyrs of Uhud. What's the evidence? The evidence is that the Sahaba, the companions, Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman, did not do this prayer after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's death. Now, question. How one reconciles between the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his saying, Wallahi ma akhafu alaykum an tushriku ba'di. By Allah, I am not afraid that after me you will worship others besides Allah. And his saying, أَخْوَفُ مَا أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمُ الشِّرْكَ الْأَصْغَرِ, the thing that I most fear for you to fall in is the lesser shirk. How to reconcile between these two statements? The answer, what is intended here in this hadith, that he is addressing some particular people. He was addressing a group of people. And these people whom he was addressing, he was not afraid that after him they will worship others besides Allah. Otherwise, we know that the shirk will occur in this ummah. And the Prophet ﷺ mentioned this when he said, you will follow and trail the path of those who before you. This brings the end of the discussion on this hadith. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who understand that and benefit from it. إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا.